It's 101.9 The Mix. It's McCabe and Lisa Allen backstage at Lollapalooza 2023, and now joined by a Chicago native, Kidd Kenn. What is going on?
Yeah. Stop playing. How y'all feeling?
Feeling good. How are you feeling? This is your first Lollapalooza.
I'm feeling amazing. I love Lolla. It's really treating me like home.
Listen, I'm feeling warm. Is anybody not going to talk about that? I am hot and disgusting right now.
I feel good. I feel way better today.
Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, now do you feel like, okay, the performance is kind of done. Now you can just hang out.
Yeah, I'm just chilling out, looking cute.
Yes, yeah, you are. You do. You look like immaculate right now, which I'm like, first of all, what is going on? I need a better setting spray, apparently.
I was
going
to say, like, let's at least describe for those who are listening. It's kind of like a chrome look you got going on.
Yeah, it's a chrome look. You know, that's what it's given today. Yesterday was pretty in pink. Today is chrome.
Yes, it's like futuristic, kind of.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Back to the future.
So how long out do you, like, plan your outfits for Lala? Because I'm kind of a psychopath. I start months out.
So to be honest, I bought this outfit this morning.
What? I love that. That's the way to do it.
I woke up early and I'm like, I need an outfit. And I went and bought it.
And you just went and got this today? And this came together today?
Today. I was on crunch time too. I was literally in the store for like 15, 20 minutes. I'm like, fuck it.
Like, I feel like I'm just impressed at this point. That went well. That worked out nicely.
I need something like that. You would, like, at least be able to track me down if
yeah,
you saw
can you
me.
Help
I would
him?
Just shine
can you
on
help this. Yeah.
Sure, write some stores down. You will love.
Okay, I would love that. I need, like, a full new wardrobe. So, Kidd Kenn, you could definitely help me out.
Yeah.
Now, you know, let's go back to yesterday. This was your first performance at Lollapalooza. How much prep went into it? And just, like, what was that experience like for you?
It was, like, amazing. Like, I spent, like, 2-3 weeks practicing with my dancers, finding dancers, and just really picking the songs and everything, the look and every how I wanted every little thing to go. So it took a lot into it, but it was so fun. It was so worth it. It was something that I was always waiting for in my career, a big stage like this. So the fact that I could do it with Lala, mind blowing.
I do kind of feel like coming up in Chicago, like you grew up here, and now to be able to actually be on stage at Lollapalooza, because this is like our big thing, like we all hang our hat on this, and you were like, excuse me, I'm on stage today.
Yeah, I'm on stage, and the crazy part about it is I've never been to concerts before I started performing at them, so like I never,
really?
I've never been to a Lolla concert.
Wow.
So why
now
not?
I
mean, you're into music. How have you not like gone to festivals? Like just, it's just something you weren't really into?
It's not even that. I was just so focused on other stuff. When I got into the music, I'm like, okay, I want to do this for me now. Like, I don't want to go see nobody. I want to see me on the stage.
Yeah, I was going to say, do you think you would just be, like, distracting from the
goal?
Yeah,
it's like, I'd be thinking, like, oh, that should be me the whole time. I wouldn't even be paying them no attention.
Wow, I love that honesty. I love that
Well,
honesty.
I do want to say that coming to your first festival, you know how to do it because I think you have to be the only person here with your own doll.
Dude!
I mean, it's amazing.
This is
the Kenn doll. The Kidd Kenn doll. Tell us about the doll. How did you get a doll? How do you? How does this happen? And it's at Target.
Yeah.
So you know, me and Target got a relationship. I love Target.
Hey.
we got a relationship. Last year we did something, and this year we just wanted to take it bigger. And they came to me with a doll idea, and they let me have full creative on it. So like, I picked the skin tone, how I wanted it to look, the hair, the outfit, the shoes, and everything. The hair changed colors from blue to pink. With heat and cold air.
Come on, like Hypercolor back in the day.
Yes, it come with heels, and it come with a cute little set, and it come with a vinyl. And on the side is a QR code you can scan and play my game with my music playing in the background.
Oh, my God, I love this. Actually, this is very well thought out, especially with, I mean, like, Barbie is, like, what everybody is talking about.
No, literally, and it really just happened so, like,
unexpected.
Yes, wow. It was so unexpected. We didn't even know like the Barbie movie was coming and stuff.
That is the stars aligning for you.
For
and I think
sure.
That's a good thing.
Thank you. Yes. Yeah. That's literally what everyone said. That's literally what I've been saying.
I mean, have you seen the Barbie movie yet?
I have, and I love it, and I want to go see it again.
Yeah? Okay. How do you feel about all of the Kenn dolls though? Were you just kinda like what?
I was really like, because I didn't see me. Like, I'm the only Kenn doll that really matters. I'm the only Kenn doll with a Kenn doll. So like, why wasn't I on there?
Well, I was going to say, look, with the success of that movie, there will probably be a Barbie 2, I'm thinking.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Maybe, I mean,
the fact, Kenn.
Cameo, yes. Cameo, yes.
Let's make that happen.
I'm going to be rapper Kenn, period.
Yes. Okay, look, I will go see that movie. I will go see that movie 100%. That'd be amazing, yeah.
Literally.
Now, also, let's talk about your new song, Coming. Yeah. Tell us about the song, when you wrote the song.
I'm like, oh, I wonder what the inspiration was.
Yeah. So I was in L.A. with one of my favorite producers, Levi. Shout out to him. And he'd been working on this different sound with, like, you know, Egyptian sounds and stuff, like real sexy stuff. Ooh. And I just wanted to, like, play with it. He played the beat. And when he played the beat, all I thought of was coming. Like, I got him coming. So, like, literally,
it
like,
spoke
I
just, to you.
So this just, one came from the beat.
It literally like, came from the beat. Like, it just spoke to me. Like, when I heard it, coming popped in my head. And I basically made the song around coming in different, like, ways. Like, coming physically, coming mentally, coming.
Right.
All that.
I actually kind of love that we are discussing this right now.
Of course.
I'm like, let's
it's
just get down into it.
Yeah,
yeah, we have I like
to.
This.
Now, is this also going to be a part of like a bigger body of work for you? Is it going to be like a full album
so
coming?
I'm working on an EP. It's called Busy Being Bad. We acting bad all year.
What is it?
Busy Being Bad.
Yeah. Busy Being Bad.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. And it's nothing but
full of energy.
Full of energy, full of fun songs, make you want to go outside, have fun with your friends, uplifting, positive music.
Oh, man. Okay, I like that. I'll buy that ticket all day.
Yeah, period. You're going to love it. I'm telling you.
Yes. Well, we are looking forward to your EP. Congrats on playing your first Lolla and making
you.
It out here. And congrats on the Kidd Kenn doll. Yeah, is this like so available in Target? People can go get this, your doll?
Only at Target. No Walmart, none of that. Just Target.
Okay.
This is how relationships start and stay.
Yeah, we... Only Target over here. If you ain't shopping at Target, what is you doing?
I am looking forward to see what is happening in your future because you have done so much already.
Thank you.
It's very exciting.
I really appreciate
yeah.
that.
And from one Southsider to another, really. That's
Period.
Really amazing to see. Congratulations.
Thank you, boo. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kidd Kenn, for stopping by 101.9 The Mix.
Thank you, guys, for having me.
We love you.